Lindsay?
16.
16.
Negative 2 times 7 minus n plus 4.
Because, like, I got the negative 10 and just didn't get the 2n, so I didn't know.
Okay. So remember that distributive property, you're going to multiply both of these by the negative 2. Distribute the negative 2 to both of these terms. Negative 2 times positive 7 is negative 14. Negative 2 times negative n is what?
2n.
2 times negative is a positive. 2 times n is what 2n means. It means 2 times n.
Yeah, we got help from math.
Which math teacher?
Rippy.
Rippy told him it was just
N. I thought you told me she didn't know what she was doing.
On 16, I got
this. On the one.
That's just on the one. She thinks Rippy went to school.
More science.
She thinks.
All right. Hey, do you want to have me like rush through an explanation and throw homework at you at the end of class?
No.
What you're doing now is affecting the end of class. You have a finite amount of time. Every bit we use, it's used. Let's use it wisely, okay? Now we have a 2n, right? That's an n term. These are 2n's. And here we have some 1's. Can't put n's together with 1's, but we can put 1's with 1's, okay? Mm-hmm. So if I put this 2n out here and I take these negative 14 ones and I add 4 ones. How many ones am I left with? Negative 10 ones. Mm-hmm.
So wait, I cheated. So
now 2n minus 10 or negative 10 plus 2n. They're the same.
That's good. Negative 10 plus n.
So when we see the distribution, I don't care who told you that, if they told you, whatever. We need to distribute the negative 2. Distribute this multiplication of negative 2. Negative 2 times negative n. Negative times negative is positive. 2 times n is 2n. Okay? Emma?
Will you do 18?
I will.
What
is
okay.
What's your question about 16?
Oh, my question about 16. So, like, I got all of them but 18 wrong. And I think it's because I didn't distribute, but still slightly not entirely understanding it. With the distributing thing. Like,
okay, so what did you not understand about what we just did?
Well, I understand what we just did. It's just like when I did it though at home, because I use the don't put ones and ends together rule. And
don't
then,
add ones and ends.
Yeah.
Okay. But multiplying is different. Let's talk about that for a second. Because it's a common misunderstanding. I see ends and ones and ends. Well, I'm not supposed to put those together, so then you don't multiply them. That's a completely different operation. Okay, let's look at 2 plus 5n. Well, that is all you can say about it. You can't add 2 ones to 5 n's because, you know, for the same reason, I should have a bunch of different things. Here we go, here's 3, 4 markers, and what else do I have?
Those things.
We got 4 markers and 4 little cube things. Okay?
But those don't go together
right.
Because they don't fit together.
So we don't have 8 of anything. We have 4 markers and 4 little cube things. Right? It's like we have 2 ones and 5 n's. We don't have 7 of anything, so we don't have 8 of anything here. We have 4 of these and 4 of these. Here we have 2 of these and 5 of those. Just so that it doesn't sound like I'm making it up or something, this is 1 plus 1 is 2, right?
Yeah.
That's what I mean by there's 2 of these. 2 ones added together, and we can collect them and have 2 of them. This is, to write this out the long way, 5 n's added together. Okay? Now, if I try to add them, it would be like trying to put those markers and those cube things together and say there's 8 of them.
That doesn't work, though.
Right?
This is making a lot more sense.
So, 1 plus 1 plus n's with all these n's plus ones.
Actually,
I can't put the n's with the ones, and so there's the don't put ones and n's together. But it's different when we multiply.
Well, actually, you could use markers for math things, and then you could use the cubes for math things. But technically, you can't put them together and make math. But with this, with the numbers, you can't.
Well, yeah, we could call them something that's the same, but then the math gets lost.
Yeah.
All right, now let's look at 2 times 5n. What does 5n mean?
5n's.
We can look at it this way. 5 times,
times
n, right? Yeah, 5 times n.
So you can multiply it, and then you can get 10n.
Right. I'm just multiplying 2 by 5. Multiply that number by n. If I had 3 numbers, like 2 times 5 times 12, I could multiply the 2 and the 5, right? And multiply that result by 12, and it's no different here. 10 times n, it's just we don't know what n is, so it just kind of hangs out and waits for its identity. And once we know what n is, we could multiply it by 10. Right? There's no problem multiplying a not n by n, right? Because here's the key, we're multiplying and not adding. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Well, why can you multiply but you can't add?
Well, okay, I can't add for the same, you know, just common sense reason of not being able to put these together and have 8.
Well, you're putting the 2 and the 5 n together.
Okay, so let's see. That multiplication would be like, okay, I have a pen. And for every pen, I have 2 blocks. Okay? I'm not trying to add them together. I'm saying that every... This is hard to... This is silly. Can I put these in? Put them in something.
So
you
can
see
blocks.
Multiplication. Okay.
One is very angled. Okay. So imagine I have this box. Okay. Here, let's look at 2 boxes and 3 of these cube things. Can I add them together and say there's 5?
No.
Yes.
Because
no.
They're the same
no.
thing.
They're not
they're
the
not
same
the
thing.
Same
this
size.
Is a clear plastic
they're
container.
The same shape.
I suppose.
They're
if
not
you want to make this
thing.
Harder, you can, but you can
you
also
have
just
6
see what I'm
squares.
Trying to say. I have 2 of this kind of thing and 3 of this kind of thing. I'm not going to put them together and say I have 5 because they're different. Different kinds of things. Okay? I realize you can say, oh, they're all cubes. And if you want to make it more difficult, then I guess we could. I'm saying this kind of cube, we'll consider them different things. Just like ones and n's are different things. And I'm not going to put these together and say that I have 5. Let's consider these to be different from these. Okay? Aside from the fact that they're both cube shapes, it's all they have in common. These are completely different. They're different. Different sizes. Okay? Yes?
How is it that you're capable of holding them without holding them? They're just between your fingers.
I'm just squishing them together with these 2 fingers.
Oh.
Okay? But here's what multiplication would look like. Let's say I have a box, and in this box, I have
4.
One of these cube things. Both cube things. Okay.
Then you have 1 box for every 4.
Multiplication is saying, well, what if I had 5 of these boxes?
20 cubes.
I have 20 cubes.
Yeah.
Right? It doesn't matter that they're different. The multiplication is 5 groups of 4. Okay? If I get, I can't because I don't have 5 of these, but if I had 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 of these boxes, and each box had 4 little cubes in it, we could figure out how many cubes there are by saying 5 times 4. It doesn't matter that this is a different thing than this, because we're not trying to combine them and say they're the same thing. We're just trying to figure out how many of these are there, okay? We have 4 of these. How many times?
5 times.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5 times. 5 times 4. 4, 4, 5 times, 5 times 4. We can't add them. I'm not trying to add them. I'm not adding this 4 to this one thing and saying that there's 5 of these. Multiplication is different. It's saying if I had 5 of these little boxes with 4 each, and I line them all up, that's 5 times 4. That'd be 20 cubes, 20 of them little cubes. Right? What that would look like, if we're talking about units, that would be 4 cubes, I mean small cubes, the small colorful cubes, times 5. Here we go. 5 cubes per box. 5 cubes per box times 5 boxes. Okay. You could look at this like a multiplying fraction. The box units would cancel the box units. You'd have 20 cubes. So here we're not, I mean, that is, you could use the word combine for that, I guess, but we're not trying to collect and add them together and make two different things the same thing or some new thing. Okay? We're multiplying. Saying 2 groups of 5 groups of n. And our experience, we know multiplying numbers, we can just multiply these 3 together. These are 3 numbers multiplied together. I can multiply these 2 and get 10. Right? Whenever n is known, I can just take n and multiply by 10. It'd be the same as multiplying n by 5 and then multiplying that by 2. Okay? So 2 different things. 2 ones, 5 n's. But what 2 times 5 n is saying is like I have the 5 n's. 2 times. I have that, the 5 n's, 2 times. So I'll just copy that. Right? This is the times 2. 2 times 5 n. 5 n, 2 times. And how many n's is that?
10 n's.
10 n's. Right?
Can you do like the same thing but with the moon? Divide like 5 n divided by 10 n divided by 5.
We could do 10 n divided by 5. 10 n divided by 5 is just kind of the reverse of multiplication, is saying if I had 10 n's and I cut them, let's just say, into 5 groups, right? How many would be in each group? So we would just have, well, here's 10 n's. Can we use this one? Not confuse anybody? 10 n's. Okay.
Yeah.
Split them into 5 groups. Let's do the red here. Well, I'll go like this. Now, do I have 5 equal groups?
Uh-huh.
And in each group, how many n's do you have?
Two.
2 n's. So 10 n divided by 5. 2n, because there's 2n in each group. Okay? Is that helping?
Yeah.
Alright, so adding, yes, you're right. You cannot add 2 different things. Ones and n's, can't add them. But when you go to multiply, it's a completely different kind of a thing. We have 5 times n, or n plus itself 5 times, we have that twice. Okay? So we have a total of 10 n's. We're just counting up n's. So, talk about that a lot. Just give your brains a break on all of that talk and try another one. What other one do we have a question on, JC?
21.
21. Not gonna work. There we go. 1 plus 7 times 1 is 3b. Now, you might be tempted to add 1 and 7 and get 8. But remember the order of operations. Look at this 7. You can add it to the 1.
Oh, we can multiply.
You can multiply it by whatever. It doesn't really matter what it's multiplied by. It's multiplied by 7. Do we multiply first or do we add first?
Multiply.
That 7 should get multiplied before we start adding it to stuff. All right, so now we'll look at what it is multiplied by. It's multiplied by parentheses, which requires the distributive property. Required? No. So we need to distribute the 7 into the parentheses. 7 times 1 is 7.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, 7 times negative 3b. You got it? 1 plus all that stuff. Okay, now this 7 just happens to be 7 because it was 7 times 1. It's not being multiplied by anything. Now that's free to be added to the 1. They're the same kind of thing. They're both 1s, 7 1s, and the 1 more 1 is 8 1s. Minus 21b, those can't go together. We cannot take 21b's from 8 1s. It just doesn't compute. It's like taking 4 markers from 3 little cubes. You can't take markers from cubes, you can't take b's from 1's. So it's done. Or negative 21b plus 8 is the same. Okay. Other questions about 21? About 21?
Uh-huh.
Yes, question.
So if it's 7 times negative 3b, it'd be negative 21, and then that's 8 minus 21?
This is 8 minus 21b.
What if you don't have that minus? What if it was a positive?
If this was a positive?
Yeah.
It would just be 8 plus 21b. this one positive, if I change this from blue to adding, well then 7 times 3b, positive 7 times positive 3b would be a positive 21b, and so in the end this would wind up being just a plus 21b instead of minus.
So you don't have a, like,
No. Here we have 1 plus 7 times 1 is 7. 7 times 3b is 21b. Right? So plus 7 plus 21b. And these add together, they're 8. 8 plus 21b. Okay? All right. I'm going to take somebody new, Emma. 22. 22. 3 minus 8, 7. Oh. Right. So now I've got this negative here attached to the 8. It's got to get distributed as well. Make sure you don't do 3 minus 8 is negative 5. We're not going to do that because, why? Why am I not going to do 3 minus 8 is 5, negative 5?
Multiplying those first.
Multiplying the 8 by the parentheses. So the 3, not really going to do anything yet, not going to combine with anything yet, it just hangs out there. Alright, so I distribute the negative 8 to the positive 7.
Negative
56. Then I distribute the negative 8 to the negative 5n.
Positive
40n. Positive 40n, you got it. Positive 40n.
But wouldn't it just be 40n? Wouldn't that be the same as plus 41?
It would be the same as, okay, 40n, 40n, and positive 40n are the same, yes. But to just say 40n, then you're kind of like, well, what do you want me to, it is a positive 40n, are you adding that 40n, are you multiplying with that 40n? Right, we have to indicate what's going on here, right? The result of multiplying the negative 8, distributing the negative 8, is we get a negative 56, right? So we're going to subtract 56, we get a positive 40n, we're going to adding that 40n. One last thing, 3 minus 56, those are all of the ones, so we have negative 53 plus 40n. Dalton?
Why does the positive 40n, why did you use, why did you put the plus sign and make it, like, I know that's a positive sign, but why did you make it a plus? Can you do something else?
What else can I do?
Anything you could do, negative 3 minus negative 56 times positive 40, and...
Oh.
Really?
Well, I think I kind of see what you're saying there. What we need to do to confirm that we're just going to add the 40 in, let's just review distributive property real quick, okay, using some numbers, all right? I didn't get a chance to show you the distributive property, but I'll tell you what I mean by that. Okay, so let's look at the distributive property, but we won't have n's and x's and stuff, we'll just have some numbers, okay? Like 3 times 5 plus 7, okay? So 3 times 5 plus 7. Now we don't have to use the distributive property here. I'm using this simple example to show you, to maybe give you confidence in the distributive property as I've been explaining it. Okay, so if we could just do anything like Dalton said, right, then we should be able to distribute this 3 and then, you know, just do whatever we want. But we do know what this should come out to be, right? Can somebody tell me for sure we know that this should come out to be the number what?
Positive.
It should be positive. 3 times some positive number, right? We could just add 7 and 5. 7 plus 5 is?
12.
Okay. You know what 3 times 12 is?
36.
So this, we know for sure, without the distributive property, pretend we never heard of the distributive property, we know for sure we would add these first because they're in the parentheses, multiply by 3, and get 36. 12 times 3 is 36. But, let me show you that by distributing and adding the two products we get here, we'll get the same thing, we'll get 36. 3 times 5 is 15. 3 times 7 is 21. Now, if I multiply 15 by 21, I'm not going to get 36, right?
You have to add it.
Add it, right? Starting to see it there, Dalton?
Yeah.
We would add it.
Not where I meant, like.
You said
you
we
wouldn't
can
do, for like 5 plus 7, you wouldn't do positive 30s, positive.
Or plus 36.
Yeah, you wouldn't do positive 12.
12, where would 12 come from?
Okay, so if you would do 5 plus 7, it's just like common sense. You wouldn't write down you wouldn't write down the positive sign 12. You just write 12.
Right.
That's what
yeah, that's what I'm saying is that's how we know that we should get 36. Like whatever we do, however we twist this around and do this differently, we know we should wind up with 36 because this is equal to the number 36. So when we distribute the 3 to the 5, you get 15, and the 3 to the 7, you get 21, and we add them together, we get 36. It's not proof that the distributive property works, but it's an example of it.
Not that, I just meant with the negative and positive sign, why would we have to put the positive sign?
Well, here's a positive sign.
That's plus.
Yes.
Well, you could, that's kind of weird. Yeah, that's really weird.
So 15 positive.
I get
yeah.
You. I think I felt the same way you're feeling now.
Because if that was a positive sign, it would go with 21, and it would be 15 times positive, 15 times positive 21.
Okay. But we at least know that that can't be right because we should get 36 and 15 times 21 is not 36.
Yeah.
So let me show you why you have to add the two numbers you get from distribution. Okay?
Okay.
I'm going to use a rectangle. We can use rectangles to see multiplication, right? We've done it many times. How do we use a rectangle to see multiplication? What about the
area?
The area. The area of a rectangle is a like a visual aid to see multiplication. So, I'm going to make a rectangle that multiplies 3 by parentheses 5 plus 7. Okay? 3 on one side. Okay? And 5 plus 7 here, like from here to there, right? Let's say that's 5 and that's 7. Okay? Okay? That's 5 plus 7, or 5 plus 7 is 12. That side would be 12, just like this would be a 12. Okay? And I could add them together and say 12 and 5, 3 times 12 is 36. Okay? But I want to show you the distributive property. So I'll just break it into two rectangles. Okay? Well, here's a rectangle, here's a rectangle. What's the area of this rectangle?
15.
15, right? 15 squares will fit inside here. That's the area of this rectangle. What's the area of this rectangle? 21. To get the area, now that I know that the area of this rectangle is 15 and the area of this rectangle is 21,
yeah.
Right, you would add them together. 15 plus 21 would give me the area
36.
Of the whole rectangle. Does that help, Dalton?
I've got that the entire time, but
okay. Why
do you have to, like, the plus sign and the positive is, they're totally different things.
Why are they the same sign?
It could be 15 plus negative 21, or it could be just 15 plus positive 21, but you don't have to put the positive sign.
Well, I didn't put plus positive, I just said plus 21.
I know, but you're saying the plus sign is a positive.
It is.
But then why is it the same? They're two different things. Although they both mean to add together, and plus we can add together, and positive means not below the zero.
To the right of zero.
Yeah, to the right of zero.
Yeah.
Then
yeah.
Why do we put it as a plus one?
Yeah.
Couldn't we put it like as like
a star?
A star. Or like
or maybe
like
opposite.
You're asking
maybe
why the symbol for plus
teeny,
and the symbol for positive is the same?
Yeah.
And why do we have to? It's confusing.
Is it? Okay. I can call this positive 15, right? Is this positive 15? Do I have to write the positive there? No, it's understood.
You don't have to.
No, you don't have to.
It's common sense.
And it makes
you know that it's a positive.
Yeah, if it doesn't have a label on it,
it's a positive.
Yeah, it's 100% positive.
Okay. So, I could think of this as like, oh, it is 15. Let's think about it on a number line. Here's 0, right? Let's say this is 15. I could just think of this as, 15 just started 15. Or I could think of it as 0, move to the right from 0, 15, okay, which is what I did when I drew the number line. I started at 0 and went to the right 15. So in that way, in that kind of loose way, addition and positiveness are related at least. They're not exactly the same thing, but they do mean to the right this much, right? To the right this much. So just a positive by itself means 50 to the right just of 0. Now if I put plus 21, that means 21 to the right of where I just started, which was 15 to the right of 0. I moved to the right 15 and moved to the right 21 more, which puts me a little bit farther than what I put. Right, and that's 36. So if I've answered your question, I hope I have. If I haven't, we'll have to
have a
one-on-one some other time. Okay. It's a good question. It's just that I can't spend all class on it. All right, so that's 22. Avery?
Number 18.
Number 18, negative 4p. Minus 1 minus 6p. I remind you that I have a negative in front of something, like a negative in front of an x, which means really negative 1 times x. A negative in front of the parentheses really means a negative 1 times the parentheses. Then I will distribute the negative 1, both of these. Negative 1 times 1 is negative 1. Negative 1 times negative 6p is positive 6p. We have negative 4p plus 6p is a positive 2p.
Actually, that's not right.
Right. Are you ready to do a couple on our own, right? Unassisted,
yes.
A little review, and show that you can distribute.
Yeah, totally. I'm up for the fact.
You need it, you should always hang on to the work. Yeah, we're done with it. Everything is how we multiply. Just a helpful reminder, make sure that if there's a negative number being distributed, that you distribute the negative as well. Positive times negative is negative, negative times negative is positive. Okay, so let's clear our desks. Every day. You're going to distribute the 3, the 2x, 6x, 3 times negative 7. 21, and those can be put together. Talking about whether or not you got it right, not helping us. Thank you. 5x minus 4, no, we're not going to try and subtract that because negative 4 is multiplied by these parentheses, so we'll distribute. Okay, 5x is just going to hang out there. Negative 8x, negative 4 times 1, negative 4. 5x minus 8x is negative 3x. Minus 4, and that's it. Yes?
So, could you do negative 3x plus parentheses negative 4?
Of course.
Okay.
Yes?
I don't know why, but I did 5x times negative 8.
You're not the only one. I've seen people do that. They get a little bit confused. They get multiply happy.
I didn't distribute the 4. I distributed the 5x like, times 2x and the 5x times 1.
Ooh. Careful. You gotta just think. For a second, like what is being multiplied, right? The negative 4 is being multiplied, 5x is, you know, it's like being added to whatever you get here. Okay, now we have, I knew we would need some more practice. That's pretty much what we have. Okay? What should we do with this? We got 6 problems here. And the only thing that's different about these is they're, you know, instead of number 2, you might have a couple of more turns thrown in there. See if you can keep it all straight. Hold on to the scrapbook. Put them in a scrapbook.
I
cherish
them.
JC is a great word.
Yeah.